organization called Shabazz Village out here in Oakland, California. We represent El Hajj Malik Shabazz family here on the West Coast. I guess you can call it, you know, Malcolm X West Coast, which is a little better than East Coast, in my personal opinion, because I don't think they have the same energy as the West Coast has, but I'm a little, what do you call that, biased? But I came here last year and I mentioned that as one group of Muslims, we have a time in history we call Ashura, where we remember those who are martyred and those who are sacrificed in the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, his family. And every year we come together, we remember that during the month of Muharram. And so a friend of mine, Brother Hussein, asked me to come out here and mention that for you to come out here today and remember the trials and tribulations of young African-American males and other people oppressed under the name of Oscar Grant. It is very important because even though you may not see a lot of numbers here today, know that in history, things started off small and they grew. It is historically known that good movements start with small group of people because you're able to commit. And so when we look at this venue we're at here, and we realize that Oscar Grant was martyred and killed here, that we should recognize that in a metaphysical way, this building, these trains, these trees, these lights, they remember his sacrifice, even if the people don't, because there's something there in sacred places. And when somebody gives their life out of place, that place becomes what's sacred. And unfortunately, American culture has taken sacredness out of the culture. But sacredness is there. That's why you see the people up in North Dakota protesting. Because the Dakota land is sacred land. Right? If you go to the Audubon Ball where Malcolm X is martyred, it's a sacred place because he was killed there. So Ferguson becomes sacred. Right? Little Bobby Hutton, when he was martyred, this becomes a sacred place. When the Panthers, every place in the world where somebody sacrificed is sacred. So as you gather here today, don't look at this only as a vigil or memorial, but it's like a pilgrimage to a place. And when you make a pilgrimage, any place you go, the point of the pilgrimage is to re-energize you. It is to get you back going and energize, say, hey, I can make it. I can let it happen. If you look at a place called Karbala, where the Prophet Muhammad's grandson, Imam Hussein, was martyred, people go there and get re-energized to continue the movement of Imam Hussein. So when you come here today, you should re-energize yourself for the struggle for human rights, because Oscar Grant is a symbol of the struggle of human rights worldwide. There's Oscar Grants in Africa and Asia and Europe, all over the world, young men and women who are given the opportunities to succeed because of a system of systematic slavery and oppression has held them down. And so the question comes for us, what are we going to do? Small numbers is good for me. I like small numbers. You can go to war with small numbers, you know what I'm saying, and go out there. They say Crazy Horse told the people what? When Custer and them was coming with the U.S. military, and it was a small number of Native Americans, Crazy Horse told them it's a beautiful day to die. Because saying it's a beautiful day to die, hey, I'm going to give it my all. We don't need everybody. We don't need big numbers. We need committed people. And as you know, if you here, you committed. Everybody not here because everybody's not committed. And so take that commitment, re-energize yourself, and ask yourself, what are you going to do in 2017? We should take the energy of the sacrifice of Oscar Grant and use that and prepare ourselves for 4 years of craziness. 4 more years of a reality TV show. 4 more years of discrimination and racism by a leadership that has come into power that the media refuses to say, that this same leadership said that the black brothers who were accused of raping that woman in Central Park, he put an ad out saying to send them down. And when they're found not guilty, he continued to say what? Prosecute them. So here you have a leadership who is already engaged in the prosecution of young black men like Oscar Grant. You have a leadership of a man who is a sexist, who is discriminatory, who wants to go and build a wall, knowing he can't build a wall, but the fact that he would say build a wall, right? Can you imagine if I said, let's build a gas chamber? Oh my goodness, well, you know, I'm not really going to do it, but let's just say it for the sake of saying it. And so when you look at what's come up in 4 years, for a lot of young people, I tell them all the time, the one good thing that might come out of this, I'm an old man, so I grew up in the 80s. And all I saw was Republican presidents, from Reagan to Bush. And if you notice, the best hip-hop in the world came out of the Republican era. The best hip-hop in the world came, why? Because they suppressed us, we had to come with something. So I'm hoping that this new hip-hop goes back and it starts to reflect the people. But maybe sometimes you need to get your ass whooped a little bit to start reflecting the people. Maybe you need to feel a little pain. Because they talk about this millennial time. I'm not a millennial. I hope you don't consider yourself a millennial. But all this exceptionalism, and you get everything. No, it's time to dig in, pull up your straps, and go to work. And I'm going to end you with this. I'm good friends with Colin Kaepernick, right? And I was with him and asked him, interesting question. I'm sharing it with you because he never said, I said, hey, man, you took the stand or the kneel, and you're standing up. He actually right now killing the Seahawks right now, so I'm proud of that, right? And he's doing good. And I said, how do you feel with the media against you? How do you feel with all these negative energies? And he gave a beautiful answer. He said, I feel free. That's it. I feel free. And so in 2017, let's all get free. All power to the people.